Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Today let me show you how to create a shortcut for your iPhone or iPad that will let you resize photos. MacMost is brought to you thanks to a great group of supporters. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon. There you could read more about it, join us, and get exclusive content. So this is a situation that a lot of iPhone and iPad users come across all the time. They need to upload a photo to a website, but the website won't accept a full-size image. The file is just too big. Now on a Mac, you could just resize the photo by exporting it out of the Photos app or using any number of other apps to resize it. You could do the same on your iPhone or iPad by getting another app, bringing in the photo, resizing it, and saving it out. But you could also create a shortcut to do this for you very easily. So let's create the shortcut by going to the Shortcuts app. Then I'm going to hit the plus button at the top to create a new shortcut. I'm going to hit the three dots button there and I can name it. So let's name this one Resize Photo. I'm going to remove Show in Widget because I don't need to see it here in the Shortcuts app, but I do want it to be in the Share Sheet so that I can hit the Share button when I'm in the Photos app and share out the image resized. Now the types I want to change from anything to just images. So I'll hit Deselect All and then I'll select Images. Then I'll hit Done. So now it says Accept Images at the top. So the first action I want to add is getting those images from the input. So I'm going to hit the plus button. Then I'll hit Media. So if I look in here, I can look for Get Images from Input. And you can see it says Get Images from Shortcut Input. Now I want to add another one. And this time I'm going to do Resize Image. You can see it right there. Now it's going to resize the images and I could set it to be a width, so 640 wide by whatever the height would be that would match that width. So that's pretty good, but I mean you could set that to something else if you wanted. So like let's set it to 600. If you really wanted to get complex with your shortcut, you can prompt for a number and then you have to enter it. Or you could just select Ask Each Time right there and then it will prompt you to fill in that information every time you run the shortcut. It's not as pretty as using the prompt, but it'll work. But we're just going to stick with making it really simple for this. So then I'm going to hit the plus button again and I'm going to do Convert Image. And this will allow me to save it out basically as an image type. So I don't care what I brought in. It could have been a PNG or a TIFF or something else. But I can convert it to a JPEG. I can select JPEG there and there are different options. Now I'm going to add one here and this is going to be under Documents. So I'm going to exit out of Media here and then go to Documents and then I'm going to look for Save File. So I've taken in the image, I've resized it, I've converted it to JPEG in case it wasn't already, and now I'm going to save it out so it's a file rather than something in the Photos app. So I don't want to fill up my Photos app with alternate versions of the same photo. I want to save this out as a file. And the file I can attach to an email or upload to a website. So it's already set for save the converted image and it's going to use the service iCloud Drive. I can go into that and use any other service I have installed. So I can do Dropbox for instance. And I'm going to have Ask Where to Save checked. If I were to get rid of that, it would automatically save it to a place inside of the Shortcuts folder. So that could be a quicker way to do it. But I like the idea of asking where to save it so I can put it where I want. And that will complete the script. So let's hit Done at the top. Now you can see Resize Photo there. And let's go and use it. So here we are in the Photos app. And let's say I want to take a photo here like this one. And I want to upload it to a site, but I can't upload the full resolution version. It wants a smaller version. So when I'm in here, I hit the Share button. And then one of the things I will see appear here is this shortcut that we added. So there's Resize Photo. So I'll tap that and it's going to go through and do everything that we asked and then go to the end where it's going to ask us to choose where to save the file. So I'm going to select this folder here called Temp and I'll save it to that. Note that if I want to rename it, see the name there at the top, it's going to use the same name. I can tap that and I can rename the file. So I could put My Photo Done. You can see it's going to use that name. So bonus, I get to name it what I want. I'll hit Save. So now I can go over to the Files app and then I can look for that Temp folder in the Documents folder there. And I can see there's that photo I saved and it's only 103K. So much smaller than the several megs of the original photo. So the great thing about this shortcut is it will appear any place where you're dealing with photos. So for instance, you can use it in the Files app itself. If you have an image there saved as a file, you can share it and then go and resize it and save out another copy. If you're using a different Photos app or some different app that manages your photos for you, then you could also share it from there and you'll find the same shortcut there. So you could easily save out a resized version to upload online, send by email, or do whatever you want with it. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.